Well, she is a hairstylist, the star of a hit TV show, Tabatha Takes Over, and now she's the author of a new book. It's called It's Not Really About the Hair. And today, Tabatha Coffey is joining us in studio. So thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
So what brings you to Edmonton?
I'm very excited. I've never been here before, so it's very exciting. And I'm actually here this weekend is the ABA, which is a hair show for professionals in the beauty industry. So I've been here all weekend speaking to hairdressers and estheticians and salon owners, and it's been amazing.
Okay, so we were just talking about what are some of the new trends that we're seeing in hair.
There's a lot going on. Color is really strong, so a lot of redheads, a lot of blondes, like really cool frosty blondes are really big again, but that's hard for the average woman to keep up with, mm-hmm. for sure. Ombre color is still in, but it's changed. So it's now not quite as extreme as it was. Shorter hair is in and bobs are hot, so you're very hot at the moment.
I just need some crazy color. Okay, so as your book says, it's not all about the hair. So part of, a lot of what you do is about talking to salon owners about running a business, mm-hmm. not just about doing hair. So what are some of the tips that, you know, that people should look for when they're walking into a salon?
I think when a client goes into a salon, you really should look at the atmosphere. You should look if it's clean. Cleanliness is a big thing for me, because if a salon is really dirty, it tells me that the staff are really complacent and they don't care. So if they don't care about their environment, they're not going to care about the client. Mm-hmm. So that's a really big thing. If you're going to a new salon, book a consultation, have a conversation with the hairstylist, make sure that you're on the same page and that they listen to you, because that's always really traumatic for women to go to a new hairdresser and the hairdresser's not listening to them or doesn't want to hear what they want.
Right.
They want to do what they want to do. So there's nothing wrong with booking a consultation, and there's nothing wrong with going into salons and seeing how everyone is dressed, how they're behaving. Mm-hmm. Do you like the work that's coming out of the salon? How are they treating their clients? Because you want to be happy.
Right. So, and on your show, you're sometimes a bit harsh.
I'm honest.
Which, yeah, some people kind of don't take that the right way. What has response been for the most part, you know, when you walk into a salon and you say what you're really thinking?
Look, I get a lot of pushback, and the reason I get pushback is the salons I walk into and the businesses I take over, the people are really desperate. It's really high stakes for them. They're losing their businesses. Some of them are losing their homes. Some of them, you know, are losing their marriages because of the business situation that they're in. So people are resistant, and I go in and point out all the things that are going wrong and then help them to get back on track and make them better, mm-hmm. and right the ship, so to speak. But you get a lot of resistance because change is hard for people. Yeah. And although they want my help, it's really hard to hear the truth.
True. Okay, so you've now taken all of your experience and put it in a book. What does your book focus on?
My book is really, I had such a great outpouring from people saying, you know, how did you become this way? Why are you so honest? How did you grow up? How did your career develop? All of those kind of things. So my book is part memoir, part business advice and beauty advice, and really just telling people about the experiences I've had in my life, some good, some not so good, mm-hmm. that hopefully will resonate with people out there and really just help them to feel better about themselves and stronger in certain situations.
And one of the things you say is that you did feel different as a kid.
I felt really different as a kid for a lot of reasons. I was incredibly obese, so that made me different to a lot of the other kids at school, and I got teased all the time and, you know, bullied, as a lot of kids experience now. I grew up in an unusual environment, so that definitely made it different as well. My parents had a different kind of business growing up. They actually owned strip clubs in Australia, mm-hmm. so it wasn't like all the other kids at school, and they were transvestite strip clubs, so that made it even more mm-hmm. different. And a lot of those kind of things, I think, are really helpful to share with people to realize that it's okay to be different. Being right. different isn't a bad thing. It just means that you're being yourself and being true to who you are.
Yeah. And you can take it to work to your advantage.
Absolutely.
Okay, so it's true. It really is not all about your hair. So the new book, where is it available? I would think bookstores everywhere.
Bookstores everywhere, perfect. Online, but bookstores everywhere are carrying it.
Fantastic. Okay, sounds like it'll be an interesting read. Especially
Thank
your parents'
you.
Business. Thanks so much for coming
Thanks
in.
Thanks for having me.